तो हमने उसमें से डुएट बना लिया कि वो दोनों कह सकते हैं, है ना। तो लेकिन उस नज्म की खूबी ये है, जिसको अभी उसमें वीडियो में भी जिक्र हुआ जिसका, कि जिस चीज का दामन, जिंदगी का कोई भी कोना, कोई भी दामन, कोई भी आंचल, जो उसकी अपनी हद से ज्यादा खींचा, वो टूट गया, उसके सांस टूट गई, उसके माने निकल गए। और ये बात मुझे किसी और शायर में कहीं भी नहीं सुनाई दी और न देखी न पड़ी कि कोई ये बात कहे कि दिया क्यों बुझ गया जल्दी से, नहीं मिलन की रात थी, मैंने ज्यादा देर तक जलाए रखा, और उसकी हद थी एक जहां तक मुझसे जलना था, जितना उसमें तेल था, जितनी बाती थी। और या फूल क्यों मुरझा गया, ज्यादा जज्बाती होकर मैंने उसे हार में पिरोया था, बहुत भींच के पकड़े रखा उसमें, तो उसमें मुरझा गया वो, इसलिए कि मैंने डैम लेना चाहा ताकि वो हमेशा, तो आगे सारी नदी सूख गई। अब ये बात कहना मुझे वाकई कहीं नहीं सुनाई दिया कि इस एंड को लेकर, और ये कह देना जरूरी लगता था, और इस तरह से ये दोनों में शांतनु ने बांट दिया, मैं तो इसके सामने ही रखा था, और किस तरह से किया वो मुझे बता दें।
बैटरी बचा के रखूं, जब जरूरत पड़े तभी यूज करूंगा।
ज्यादा ही बचाया था,
ज्यादा ही बचा दिया था।
Oh, no. Gulzar Sahab, to always remind me of certain people I'm forgetting. First and foremost, brilliantly mixed album, not saying because it's ours, but because there is. Bishwadeep Chatterjee has mixed it. Bishwadeep, please stand up. Thank you. Also, one more name in this song, in the original you'll hear Shetar, which is just it's an unplugged kind of stuff. One of the most promising sitar players of our country, Purbayon Chatterjee. Please, Purbayon, stat. Purbayon has done an amazing, amazing job. So, it's a cliche in many generations, but it's not, especially in mine. It's a collective art form. It's absolutely a collective art form. Can't do this without. The third song, which is, again, Shaan has sung this song. I must tell you certain things which is to happen behind creating some of the songs. One anecdote I'll tell you again. He's brainchild. I was very nervous to do this album. You have to understand, this is Gurudev. It's like, I'll be killed. So he saw my hesitancy. He says, kya problem hai? I said, Maliki, what is my boundary? What am I creating on? How do I know what is relevant, what is not relevant? What did he like? What did he not like? So, in front of his desk, now there are four chairs. So I always used to come and sit in the middle chair. He said, "Tum kabhi bhi na us wale chair mein mat baithna." So I said, "Sir, kyun? Wo to hamesha khali rehta hai." Kehta hai, "Isme yahan pe Gurudev baithte hain." So I don't know why. It was a psychological thing for me that every time I was to sit down, I would greet that empty chair, like, and I would pick up this and
the main thought was to keep remembering remember the reference to whom we are working on.
But it worked for him that way.
And so what happens is that compositionally what is happening is that having heard so many songs of Rabindranath Tagore from childhood, I know his favorite movements. I know his favorite notes. Even this is, let's say, Shantanu Moitra's creation. But this this is Tagore written all over. This movement is him. Song after song after song after song, he has created this kind of melodic line just to relieve the first two lines. It's almost like Eklavya. Hearing him, hearing his work, you kind of devise what would be his favorite palette, favorite colors. And therefore, for me personally, it's a